Good evening, OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley's members, friends, awardees, and distinguished guests. Welcome to OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley's 40th anniversary and 38th Dynamic Achiever Awards virtual gala. I'm Jacqueline Liu, together with Bo Hong, who are the co-chairs for tonight's event. Organized in 1980, the Westchester Hudson Valley chapter of OCA is one of the leading social advocacy on behalf of all Asian Americans and culture organizations, promoting all Asian culture and achievements in the Westchester County and Hudson Valley region. Our talented and committed membership sponsors the full calendar of events and projects, all of which celebrate the growing presence of Asians and raise awareness of our needs and concerns. We thank our longtime sponsors, Pepsi Corporation, Regeneron Pharmaceuticals, Association of Chinese Physicians, New York Life, Huaxia Chinese School of Greater New York, and IBM Corporation. We also want to thank all OCA Westchester Hudson Valley volunteers for their hard work, dedication, and financial support in the past 40 years. Here is my co-chair of this event, Bo Hong.
Hi, everyone. Usually, this is the time we gather at the DoubleTree Hotel in Tarrytown, joined by all of you to celebrate the OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley's anniversary. 2020 is an unusual year. COVID-19 pandemic dominated most of this year. There are millions of Americans who are affected by the coronavirus physically, emotionally, and financially. Our thoughts and prayers are with them. The first responders and healthcare workers are the real heroes. Tonight, we will honor one of them. Even though we are gathering by video and celebrating virtually, we prepared a great program for you. Tonight, we will meet four amazing leaders in our community in advocacy and community services and witness the recognition of their contributions. We have ongoing silent auctions and a beautiful slideshow. Please don't forget to check out our program journal and consider joining OCA WHV as a member. We hope you have an inspiring and entertaining evening with us. Now, please welcome our chapter president, Grace Pan, to give her welcoming remarks.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very pleasant evening to all. Thank you for being with us today. I'm Grace Pan, the president of OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley Chapter. I want to extend a warm welcome to our old friends and every new face to our first ever virtual Dynamic Achiever Award Gala and the celebration of our 40th anniversary. We also have the honor to have Congresswoman Grace Meng as our keynote speaker today. Welcome. Before we proceed, I would like to first thank all the healthcare professionals, frontline responders, and essential personnel working to keep everyone safe and healthy during these unique times. Among them are some of our members and board members. Let's give them a round of big applause. With the generous support from many of you, OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley was able to help to fight COVID-19 pandemic and support those impacted by this horrific situation. We made donations to many local organizations such as Feeding Westchester, Westchester County Medical Center Foundation, Charles Wong B. Health Center, Elmhurst Hospital, and Flushing Hospital, etc. We are continuing the effort to help more business and people in our communities during the pandemic. Please join us by donating on our website and go to our online auction website to support our cause. Even though some of our activities have been canceled or postponed, we are able to host several impactful events in person or in a virtual format. We participate in a campaign to promote 2020 census, successfully host our virtual Rising Star concert in June, and work with County Executive Office to support local Asian business. Currently, we are working with OCA National to plan several signature programs, such as APAY, B3, and MAP. Stay tuned for more information. Since its founding 40 years ago, OCA Westchester and the Hudson Valley have been a champion in advancing the economic, cultural, social, and political well-being of Asian Americans and the Pacific Islanders. We have promoted civic participation and coalition building among all ethnic groups. Like never before, I feel our work is so crucial to advocate for racial equality and social justice. In response to racist and xenophobic remarks, we issue a press release to condemn the anti-Asian and anti-Chinese sentiments during the public health crisis. In response to the murder of George Floyd and countless others, we issue a press release to support the African-American community. We, as Asian Americans, stand with our Black and brown brothers and sisters to protest pervasive institutional racism and police brutality targeting minority groups. We are committed to continue fighting injustice and inequality and advocate for our Asian Americans. Tonight, we are also here to celebrate achievement of several outstanding individuals for their extraordinary contributions to their professions and communities. This year's Dynamic Achiever Award recipients are Joy Lieberthal Rowe, co-founder MAdoptee.org, and Dr. Ruling Xu, gastrointestinal pathologist and the president of the Association of Chinese Americans. This year's Community Service Award are our own board members, Rose Kong and Bill Kong. We are humbled by their accomplishment and inspired by their examples. The winners of the Youth Award will also be recognized today. Congratulations to all. Finally, I would like to thank our generous gala corporate sponsors and many individual sponsors. I cannot thank enough our gala co-chair, Bo and Jacqueline, for their hard work to make this event possible. Also, a big thank you to the rest of our board members for their time and expertise. It takes a village to build a strong AAPI presence. It is you who make our work meaningful and our program impactful. Please join with us and enjoy this evening of celebration. Cheers to another 40 years ahead. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you all for taking the precious time out of your day and evening to be online with us tonight to celebrate OCA Westchester Hudson Valley Chapter and their 40th anniversary. As one of the oldest chapters of OCA, the OCA Westchester Hudson Valley Chapter has maintained a robust legacy of youth programming, cultural heritage preservation, and civic engagement and advocacy. Every time I've visited the chapter, it is clear that this is an important hub for the Asian American and Pacific Island community here. During this COVID-19 pandemic, it brings me great honor to see the chapter and its board members support this community's frontline workers in donating supplies and standing against anti-Asian hate. Tonight, we are here to celebrate and recognize some very special people. Each of tonight's honorees were carefully selected for their exceptional professional achievements, as well as their participation in the community. And I want to congratulate them all. I want to especially acknowledge Sinfrosa Tan and Bill Kong, who have been longtime supporters of the chapters, as well as the OCA National Summer Internship Program. These two are dynamic, and as a duo, they have shown OCA what it truly means to uplift the next generation. I also want to recognize the chapter board members and volunteers, because they are heroes in the OCA family and Westchester community. To the guests and visitors this evening, I hope that you are inspired by the stories you'll be hearing, and I encourage you to stay involved through volunteering or other means of support. So I thank you for being here and enjoy the rest of your evening.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Jin Lee, Executive Vice President, OCA Westchester Hudson Valley Chapter. It's my great honor to introduce our keynote speaker, U.S. Congresswoman Grace Meng. U.S. Congresswoman Grace Meng is serving her third term in United States House of Representatives. Grace represents the 6th Congressional District of New York, encompassing the New York City Borough of Queens, including West, Central, and Northeast Queens. Grace is the first Asian American member of Congress from New York State, and the only Congress member of Asian descent in the entire Northeast. She is also the first female member of Congress from Queens since former vice presidential nominee, Geraldine Ferraro. Grace is a member of powerful House Appropriation Committee and the subcommittees on the state and the foreign operations, and the commerce, justice, science, and the related agencies. Previously, Grace served on the House Foreign Affairs Committee and the House Small Business Committee. Grace is also a senior whip and a regional whip for New York and the founder of co-chair of the Kids Safety Caucus, the first bipartisan coalition in the House that promotes child safety issues. Grace has passed several pieces of legislation in law. This includes law about religious freedom, making Queens historical site part of the National Park Services, striking Oriental from federal law. Grace is old friends of OCA and attended our previous event in the past. We're very honored to have her as our keynote speaker this year. Let us welcome U.S. Congresswoman Grace Meng.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Congresswoman Grace Meng from Queens, New York. It's my pleasure to greet you all at tonight's 2020 Dynamic Achiever Award Gala. I want to begin by thanking the Westchester and Hudson Valley Chapter of OCA for hosting this gala. I especially want to recognize and thank all the members of OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley and the awardees for your leadership and service to our community. We've all heard the statistic about how Asian Americans are the fastest growing population in the U.S. That growth rate has allowed us to gain more influence and visibility in all aspects of American life, but especially in the political arena. In the 2016 election, there were over 1 million new Asian American voters, and that made a direct impact on our representation in Congress. The 116th Congress is the most diverse Congress in U.S. history, with record numbers of women and 20 AAPI individuals having been elected. And the electorate power of our community is only expected to grow. We are expected to represent 10% of all voters by 2044. But it's not enough for us just to increase in numbers. We need to increase our civic engagement and participation as well. Change begins when we have a say in the decision-making process. And the way to make sure we are represented in that process is to show up and get involved. AAPIs have experienced a lot of disenfranchisement and discrimination from our government, but our heritage is one of strength, resilience, and a commitment to fight injustice. We have demonstrated these characteristics as we fought for policy changes, like repealing discriminatory immigration laws and eliminating use of the derogatory word Oriental in federal law, which I was proud to sponsor. When AAPIs are engaged, we can make a difference. Tonight's awardees are an inspiration to continue to the fight for a stronger future for generations to come. Congratulations to all of you, and thank you for all the work you do for our community. I hope everyone stays safe and healthy. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Miao Yi, past president of this chapter during our 25th and 26th year serving our community. I'm currently the vice president of development. We at OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley are dedicated to advancing the social, political, and economic well-being of Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders. Our priorities are to promote fair treatment and the elimination of discrimination, stereotyping, and hate crimes against any community, to advocate for a more inclusive and accessible education system for all members of our community, and to fight for comprehensive immigration reform that will improve the family visa system and create a clear pathway to citizenship.
Founding of OCA Westchester. In late 1979, OCA National Founder Kung Lee Wing drove from Maryland to Briarcliff Manor, New York, to meet up with Francis and Norton Chu at their home to convince them to launch an OCA chapter in Westchester County. On March 9, 1980, OCA Westchester became the 18th chapter of OCA. Thomas Yang, Stanley Wang, and Francis Chu drew up the chapter bylaws. Francis Chu was elected the chapter's founding president. The chapter held fundraising activities and ran projects that attracted members ranging from 18 to 80. The events brought together young people that led to 5 marriages. As Francis Chu noted, it was and always will be a lucky and auspicious chapter. The chapter recruited Dr. Chi Meng, retired president of the China Institute, as an honorary member, and Dr. Edward Mortola, chancellor of Pace University, as an advisor. Dr. Chi Meng recommended the chapter highlight accomplished Chinese Americans. Under Francis Chu's leadership, the chapter created a speakers program, From East to West, the Dynamic Achievers. The first Dynamic Achiever speaker and awardee was Dr. C.T. Wu, professor at Hunter College. This evolved into the chapter's annual Dynamic Achievers Awards program. OCA Westchester broadened the awareness of the positive impact of Chinese Americans in the local community. Through the chapter's founding members and activities, prominent donors were introduced to Pace University. Dr. Chi Meng donated a Chinese library to Pace University, and Maria Lee, Hong Kong philanthropist, donated $1.3 million to Pace to establish an Asian studies program. Charter members of OCA Westchester were Howie Chan, Johnny and Mei Chan, Roy and Bessie Chang, Jack and Rose Chow, Norton and Francis Chu, Philip and Esther Chu, Roderick Chu, Mei Ling and Arnold Ray, C.T. and Peggy Lee, Peggy W. Lee, C.T. and Nora Lin, Tai and Susan Mack, John and Irene Cao, N.T. and Mabel Wang, Stanley and Catherine Wang, T.S. and Angus Yang, Andrew and Evelyn Yuan.
Hello, everyone. My name is Laura Chen Schultz, and I'm happy to introduce Joy Lieberthal Rowe as one of the OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley Chapter 2020 Dynamic Achiever Awardees. Before I even met her, in my role at the Asian Pacific American Institute at NYU, I would see Joy's name among researchers and advocates presenting about racial identity and belonging and transracial adoption. And later, after I adopted internationally, I would see her name associated with adoptee support and networking organizations. But it was 15 years later when I reached out to a friend for a recommendation for a Westchester-based therapist who could identify and connect with my daughter's adoptee experience that I finally met Joy. And through her impact on my family, I quickly understood why I saw her name everywhere. Joy's generosity of care does not extend only to those in her counseling practice, but also to the larger community. Whether it be putting her personal story out there in a documentary or online space, or mentoring youth and families through adoptee community groups. Especially during this year, 2020, it's so important to recognize those in our community who demonstrate kindness, compassion, and care for one another. Congratulations, Joy, and thank you for all that you do.
Thank you to the board of directors and the community members of the Westchester and Hudson Valley chapter of OCA for the Dynamic Achiever Award. A personal thank you to Laura Chen Schultz for thinking of me and all her kind, generous words. When Daniel Lewis called me to share this good news, he remarked that I was the first adopted person to be honored with this award. In thinking about how to share with you the impact of such an award on one person, I wanted to share with you a memory. 25 years ago, I was on a bus to Lake George for a weekend, organized by the China Institute, to share my story of being an adopted person. Little did I know I was sitting in front of a group of elders, many who came up to me with tears in their eyes to share in whispers that they too were adopted. I was adopted by my aunt who could not have babies. I was adopted by a rich neighbor who needed a son. All of them said, "It never occurred to me that being adopted was such a part of my identity and something I never shared with my children or grandchildren." The questions, the sadness, the loneliness, the achievements, their successes, their families were all cast in a new light. That weekend, I hung out with a group of silver-haired adoptees who just discovered something new about themselves. In 25 years, I have seen the community of adoptees grow to groups all over the U.S. and overseas. Our voices have been a part of the politics of gender, identity, family planning, and what it means to be an American. Our particular experience of being a member of an American family, all the while being an immigrant with no roots, shines particular as our country is having a reckoning on who belongs, who is an American, and who is the right kind of American. Whether in a Zoom room of 2 or 82, the conversations I am privy to frustrates as they seem timeless, and embolden as they always are full of hope. I wonder where you are all in this current reckoning, if it feels different or more of the same. I am heartened that organizations like OCA found it necessary to advocate for the Asian American community so that we are not used as mere pawns in the game of who is more privileged. The pioneer group of Chinese American adoptees who were born in mainland China are approaching their third decade. No longer babies, and an amazing, inquisitive, courageous group of humans discovering their place in the Chinese and American community. And there are even more Chinese adoptees from Taiwan and Hong Kong, many who are closer to my age. So I thank you for this honor, for welcoming me into this gathering of leaders and changemakers. I come holding the door for over 250,000 Chinese and Korean American adoptees and the nearly 1 million intercountry adoptees worldwide. May our community grow, especially at a time when coming together is no easy feat, but so very necessary. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Jin Lee, Executive Vice President of OCA Westchester Hudson Valley Chapter. It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Ru Liangxu, our Dynamic Achiever Awardee. Dr. Ru Liangxu is Professor of Pathology, currently a pathologist working at White Plains Hospital. He is a founding member of Elixir Medical Laboratory and the founding member, vice president, and the chief medical officer of East Gene Laboratory, New York. Other than his professional achievement, he is currently president of ACAP, Association of Chinese American Physicians. He spent numerous hours dedicating his time to this organization, which promotes professional achievement of Chinese American physicians. During the initial pandemic of COVID-19, New York City and Westchester County was the epicenter. There was a serious shortage of personal protective equipment for the frontline workers. Since March 20th, Dr. Xu led ACAP to launch ACAP COVID-19 response efforts to assist frontline physicians. Under his leadership, ACAP received donation of more than $300,000, more than 2,000 pieces of PPE were distributed to more than 30 hospitals, clinics, police stations, and nursing homes, mainly located at most affected area in New York City and Westchester County. Dr. Xu's tireless effort during this process was remarkable. While he was working as a full-time pathologist, he spent hours and hours to secure the donation, to find the reliable sources and make the purchase, to coordinate and personally deliver the PPE to the frontliners. Dr. Xu's dedication on ACAP COVID response effort is just one example of his devotion to AAPI community. He also gave education lectures to local communities on COVID-19. He also led ACAP establishing the regular dialogues with local elected officials to address the medical-related needs in AAPI community. His effort during current pandemic showed his character as effective community leader and a dedicated advocate. Let's welcome Dr. Ru Liangxu, our DAA awardee.
Dear President, meeting organizer, honorable guest, and all Westchester OCA members, it is my great honor to accept this award. When Dr. Li told me that I was nominated for this award, I was a bit surprised and puzzled. But just a minute, I realized why I am giving this award. Because this award is not just for me, it is for our Chinese American physicians who have been fighting against the COVID-19 pandemic at the front line ever since early this year. I know this is not just for my personal honor, it is a recognition of our member of the Association of Chinese American Physicians, or ACAP, which I am representing. The past year is the most challenging year to all medical professionals in this country, particularly to Chinese American physicians in the 20th century. At the beginning of the year, when we learned that the COVID-19 outbreak occurred in China, we as ACAP doctors responded very quickly to donate personal protective equipment stocked in our clinic and office or purchase through a variety of channels. We delivered those invaluable PPE to more than 10 hospitals in Wuhan City and the suburban after overcoming tremendous difficulty of shipping, as you know. When COVID-19 became an epidemic in New York City, ACAP took the leadership to help with PPE shortage of the local hospital and medical facility. We, ACAP, mobilized our doctors and all resources, helped more than 30 hospitals, nursing homes, and other medical facilities, including one Indian reservation. Now we are preparing more for the second wave to come. In addition to that, we also, working with other sister organizations, sent out our doctors and other medical professionals volunteering in the free COVID-19 testing center citywide to help underserved people. Our doctors continue to provide best medical service in the hospital, clinics, and in their own office, no matter how bad the condition are. This is what our doctors have been doing. They are risking their lives and working tirelessly fighting against COVID-19 every day. Our doctors deserve everything for what they have done to this country, to our Chinese American people. Dear friends, we are at a critical and historic moment. This country and society are facing lots of uncertainty medically, politically, and socioeconomically. Unless we work together, and support each other, our country and society cannot have a better tomorrow. Again, I thank you for this award personally and on behalf of ECAP doctors. We, ECAP doctors, will always be with you when you need us. Thank you.
I'm Li Lin, the past president of OCA Westchester Hudson Valley Chapter. It is one of the 50 chapters and affiliates of the national organization, OCA Asian Pacific American Advocate. It is a nonprofit, nonpartisan, member-driven organization based in Washington, D.C. Each year, we work with our organizational supporters, partners, members, and other chapters to empower hundreds of thousands of Asian American Pacific Islanders. We strive to develop leadership, community involvement, and civil participation for all AAPIs. The national organization was founded in 1973, and our chapter was founded 7 years later, in 1980. This year, we are very proud to celebrate our 40th anniversary.
Hi, I'm Christine Zhao, VP of Development. What kind of programs do OCA offer? We offer advocacy, personal, and professional development programs, such as APAY Advocate, which is leadership training for high school students, APIA U Compass, leadership training for college students, B3, that is Build, Breakthrough, Believe, a leadership and networking program for young professionals, MAAP, Mentoring Asian American Professionals, a 3-session development program offering mentoring, skill building, and networking. Civic engagement, assist the Asian American Pacific Islander community in voicing its growing civic power.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My name is Jenny Koh, Executive Vice President of the OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley Chapter. Thank you all for joining our virtual 2020 Dynamic Achiever Award Gala and 40th Anniversary Celebration. It is great honor and pleasure for me to present William H.P. Kong, past National Treasurer, OCA Asian Pacific American Advocates, and Sinforosa Tan Kong, Professor Emerita, Westchester Community College. The 2020 Community Service Awardees of the OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley Chapter. William and Sinforosa, whom we fondly call Bill and Rose, and Mr. and Mrs. OCA, are pillars of OCA and of our community. They are OCA lifetime members and have worked tirelessly and passionately for more than two decades to advance the many causes and programs on behalf of OCA, both locally and nationally. Their contributions to human rights efforts, advocacy for Asian Pacific Islander Americans, passion for education, and service to the community have not gone unnoticed, and they have received innumerable accolades. To give a few examples, Bill is the U.S. Army veteran and a recipient of the Purple Heart. In 2000, Bill established the first annual Asian American Heritage Festival in collaboration with the Westchester County Parks Department during his OCA chapter presidency. He served on the OCA National Board for many years and on the OCA National Executive Council for 8 years. In 2010, Rose retired as the Joseph and Sophia Abeles Endowed Chair for Mathematics. She has received the SUNY Chancellor's Excellence in Teaching Award, the Philippine Chinese Association of America Outstanding Achievement Award in Education, and the Region 1 Pi Lambda Theta International Honor and Professional Association in Education Outstanding Educator Award for Teaching Excellence. In 2019, New York State Senate Majority Leader Andrea Stewart Cousins selected Rose as the Woman of Distinction Honoree for Senate District 35. Both Bill and Rose have been awarded the OCA National Unsung Hero Volunteer Award for their exemplary volunteerism spirit. They have established Family Scholarship Endowment Funds at 5 educational institutions to help deserving students achieve their dreams. In 2016, the YWCA of White Plains and Central Westchester presented Bill and Rose with the Mission Maker Award. But rather than listing all of their achievements, I would like everyone to have the opportunity to meet and hear Bill and Rose themselves. I am proud to introduce this year's OCA Community Service Awardees, Bill and Rose Kong. Thank you.
Thank you, Jenny, for your generous introduction. Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us to celebrate our chapter's 40th anniversary. my husband Bill and I join you in congratulating Dr. Rolling Su and Joy Libertal Ro, tonight's Dynamic Achiever awardees, and our Youth Award winners. We thank our Dynamic President, Grace Pan, our dedicated Board of Directors, and everyone who worked tirelessly to make tonight's celebration happen, our first virtual gala. Bill and I are humbled and deeply honored to receive the 2020 OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley Community Service Award and share it with our exceptional board members. We want to dedicate it to all community volunteers, COVID-19 workers, essential workers, and everyone who help keep us all stay healthy and sane during this very challenging time. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Each one of us deal with adversity in our own way. As a cancer survivor, breast cancer in 1987, and recently lymphoma, I can empathize with the suffering of many, but also hopeful that working together, though apart, wearing masks, encouraging and supporting each other, keeping the faith, we will survive and see better days ahead. Now we want to spend the next few minutes to share with you why we made a lifetime commitment to OCA, what we do to serve our community, and how we do it.
26 years ago, Alice Char called and Rose says, go talk to her. Well, I've been on the board now on this for this chapter for 26 years by answering that call. We have been OCA member for 26 years, have lifetime membership, and each of us have served as president of our chapter. We take the time to meet people in our community in different venues to let them know who we are and what OCA is about and what we do. We work to develop relationships and work collaboratively with advocacy organizations, other selected not-for-profit organizations, education institutions, and volunteer organizations to achieve common goal and to develop, maintain good working relationships with community leaders and elected officials. This all takes a lot of time and commitment, but it's worth building these networks and connection in order to be at the table. Rose and I often represent our chapter at various community functions, public event, meetings, fundraising events, and other venues to show our support and also take the opportunity when appropriate to advancing the many courses and the programs of OCA. Together with our board director, we plan and work hard to assure the success of our programs and events.
Bill and I believe in the power of education and how it can help transform one's life for the better because we are living proof. Bill and I could not have afforded our graduate education without financial assistance. I earned my master's degree from Cornell University because of the support provided by the National Science Foundation Fellowship. And my PhD from Syracuse University was funded through scholarships and graduate assistantship. I taught mathematics for 40 years, 35 of those at Westchester Community College, and feel very fortunate that my work had been widely recognized. Bill earned his MBA in financial management from Iona College with help from the GI Bill. He enjoyed his distinguished career as a financial executive in the life insurance industry for over 40 years. My parents had very little formal education, but they value education and they taught me to help those less fortunate. Bill and I also believe in giving back and paying forward. So although we have modest means, we made a commitment and over the years have established family scholarship endowment funds at 5 different educational institutions in order to assist deserving students achieve their dreams. We were also instrumental in establishing the OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley Asian Student Scholarship Fund at Westchester Community College and continue to promote donations to the fund. Bill and I also believe in providing leadership development opportunities to young Asian Pacific Islander American students. We found an ideal program to support, the OCA National Summer Internship Program, one of OCA's signature student leadership development programs based in Washington, D.C. So we established the William H.P. Kong and Sinforosa Tan Kong Internship Endowment Fund. Our trust in the program is validated because OCA intern alumni have become executive directors, legislative staffers, OCA National Executive Council members, and are leaders in the private and public sector. Isn't that wonderful?
It was only after we joined OCA that we learned so much about the history, the struggles, and the contribution of the APIAs in America. We were amazed, impressed, and turned us into lifelong volunteers and make serving our community a major commitment in our lives. Rose and I feel privileged to meet many dedicated volunteers and honored to have forged lifelong friendships with OCA members and members of other advocacy and not-for-profit organizations all over the country. For those of you who are volunteers, we thank you for your invaluable service to our community and voters. For those who are not, we urge you to consider volunteering and experience how it can help change other people's lives and enrich your own life. Rose and I thank you and wish each one of you a wonderful, safe, healthy, and joyful life.
I'm Daniel Lewis, Co-Vice President of Community Outreach and Advocacy. What kind of activities does OCA offer? Each year, we host a variety of activities and events, such as our annual Dynamic Achiever Awards and Gala, to recognize distinguished Asian Americans who have made significant contributions in their field. The Asian American Heritage Festival, to promote Asian American and Pacific Islander performing arts and culture. The Rising Stars Concert, to recognize young Asian American musicians who are passionate about music. Our Youth Awards program, to recognize high school seniors for their outstanding contributions to their local communities. Our new internship program, to provide college students with working experience. Young OCA Youth Group program, to offer high school students volunteering opportunities. Our Meet the Candidates Forum, to provide a nonpartisan channel for people to learn of their local candidates' positions. Voter registration and census, to encourage voters to participate in elections so Asian American voices are heard. Asian Americans are 6% of the county's population, and our local and national representatives should know our positions. We also encourage census participation so Asian Americans were fully counted. And a yearly national convention where you will hear amazing people talk about critical topics in the Asian American world and get to meet OCA members from across the country.
Thank you. Hi, good evening. Thank you for joining us tonight at our OCA Gala. My name is Ed Lamb, and I have the honor of presenting to you tonight this year's recipients of our Youth Awards. So our Youth Awards are broken down into several distinct categories, our Student Leadership Award and our Needs Based Awards. These awards celebrate the academic achievements of talented students from across Westchester and Rockland County schools. Our first category awards are our Student Leadership Awards. This award goes to 10 highly qualified students who have demonstrated and shown outstanding academic achievements. And before we go into the recipients of these awards, I'd like to take a quick moment to recognize the Vincent Hosang Family Foundation, whose continued support make this award possible. So thank you very much. These students, are grateful for your continued support. Thank you. So without further ado, here are this year's 10 recipients of our Student Leadership Awards. They are Rachel Del Fierro, Vivian Gu, Amy Hu, Yuri Kim, Cindy Lochner, Zoe Milstein, Luke Park, Joanna Wong, Richard Yan, and Brian Joe. Congratulations to these 10 students. And we hope that you have tremendous success for the remainder of the year and in your futures. Our next category of award is the Needs-Based Award. These awards recognize 7 students through 6 categories, right? And these students, despite significant hardships in their lives, are able to demonstrate academic success, show leadership, and make a true impact on their communities. Before we get into the recipients, I'd like to recognize the individual boards themselves and the individuals and foundations and organizations that make the awards possible. So they are the Jeanette Wong Memorial Endowment Fund, the Avon Zhao Chun Liu Award, the Jean Wood Chang Award, the Phi Lambda Westchester Award, the Ko Golden Apple Award, and the Koo Family Community Engagement Award. So thank you very much, everyone, for your support and making this award possible to recognize our students. So without further ado, the recipients of this year's awards are Yu Chin Lim for the Jeanette Wong Memorial Endowment Fund, Mei Yun Liu for the Avon Zhao Chun Liu Award, Athena Chan for the Jean Wood Chang Award, Alexei Zaretsky for the Phi Lambda Westchester Award, Matthew Melgrito for the Cole Golden Apple Award, Elizabeth Ligani for the Koo Family Community Engagement Award, and Medha Mathur also for the Koo Family Community Engagement Award. Congratulations, and wish you luck in your future. Finally, we also have an OCA Asian Student Endowment Scholarship for 2 students who are attending Westchester Community College. And we'd like to recognize these students who are continuing their academic journey. And we want to recognize them with this scholarship. And these students are Caleb S. Yu and Henry Wong.
We now come to the end of our program, celebrating OCA Westchester and Hudson Valley's dedication to advocacy and to advancing the social, political, and economic well-being of Asian Pacific Islander Americans for 40 years.
We want to thank all OCA Westchester Hudson Valley volunteers for their hard work, dedication, and financial support in the past 40 years. Please check out our program journal and consider joining OCAWHB as a member or becoming a sponsor. Silent auction will be ongoing until 9 p.m. Thank you all for joining us this evening. Good night.